choice, a choice which is not manipulated or not compromised. Education is never encouraged in our country. So women are never free from the barriers they have. They are never economically independent. They are usually treated as the cheap, unorganized labor of the country. In India, we women always have the pressure from our household to marry off soon. Either you earn your own money or marry off soon. I do not even have the freedom to travel in a general compartment in metro without being watched or stopped awkwardly by some unknown person, or without being touched, or without feeling uncomfortable. In Manipur, in Kashmir, wherever there is AFSPA, so actually their women's body is used as the perpetration of crime. So women are raped, women are threatened, women are killed. Women's womb are treated as something that denotes the purity of the class or the caste or the religion that they stand for. It is the virginity of them, it is the purity of their body only that they carry, that actually denotes how the caste or the class or the religion from wherever, or the family that they come from. It is, the culture is masculine in its nature. She asks for a place into this particular cultural space. It is masculinity that gets threatened. It is Brahminical masculinity, maybe, that gets threatened. It is Hindu masculinity, or maybe the totalitarian masculinity, that gets threatened. So the repercussion comes as soon as we women speak up our voices. It is always unbearable for the patriarchal societal structure to stand a woman's voice who is voicing her own opinion, who is talking about her own oppression, who is asking for her own right. The self-proclaimed moral guardians of the society who always like to be the custodians of a woman's choice. And it is always threatening for them if a woman asks it for herself only.